I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter.
Peanut butter. Yeah.
Welcome to the podcast.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the podcast. That is absolutely correct. It is podcast episode number 18. Just got to eat some chocolate chip cookies. I'm all wired up and ready to go.
Okay.
They were the chocolate chip cookies that come in the little break-off squares made by a company called Walmart's. And they're actually really good. Surprisingly, I think, better than the, what do you call them? The other ones, the Nestle...
the store brand, name brand ones. Yes. So.
Well, I'm allowed to say my opinion.
Okay.
You think, like, they actually listened to the podcast?
No.
Well, they did, and they sponsored us with those little chocolate chip things. What are those things called?
Cookies?
No, the chocolate chip things.
Chocolate chips.
That's not what they're called. Morsels.
Morsels.
And see, you call yourself a good cooker.
good cooker.
Yeah. All right. You know what? Let's move on with the show. Okay. So what we actually have here is, and this is where you say the title.
CheapGeek's cheap, practical, under $20 gift list for guys 2016.
Yeah. So that is CheapGeek's cheap, practical, under $20 gift list for guys 2016. Because here's the deal. I don't know what I was going to say, actually, with that.
The holidays are coming up, and you probably have quite a few people on your list that you still need to buy presents for.
Yes, and some of them may be guys.
Yes, just some of them.
Yeah, yes. And we're talking about these are gifts for guys. You know, guys who, well, I don't know how to say this about being, if your guy spends more time conditioning his beard than cutting the grass, you know, then this podcast is probably not going to be for you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
If your guy goes to Starbucks and has all the boxes checked on his cup, it's definitely not going to be for you. Yeah. If your guy's idea of coffee is Maxwell House or Folgers, this is probably for you. If your guy has a tool set that has two screwdrivers in it, either both Phillips or both straight slot, then this gift guide list is not for you.
Okay.
If your dude uses AAA to change a tire and thinks it is a necessary expense, this gift guide is not for you.
Hmm.
Yeah. If your guy calls his men's stuff like shampoo and soap and stuff like that product, this is not for you. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh. Yeah. So let's go on and...
I'm just setting the boundaries of why we're doing what we're doing.
You're setting
I felt it necessary that we need to explain who this gift guide list is for. Because it's for guys, but it's for guys.
Uh-huh.
Like dudes. You know what I mean?
Well, and you're there making mess. I might like a few of them on here.
Who?
I might like a few of these gifts.
No, I'm sorry. You're just that's not possible.
Oh, I'm excited.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. That was the very first comment I got on one of the videos. Because so far, I'm going to be making a series of videos, about 13 videos, doing a quick overview slash review of each one of these gifts on this gift guide list for guys.
Mm-hmm.
And the very first comment was, I think I know a girl who'd like this, and I would buy it for her. I'm like, okay. So, here's the deal. It's entirely possible that there may be some ladies that would like this stuff on this list, and some guys that would like this stuff on this list. And pretty much, you know what? Let's just open it wide open. If you like it, buy it. But I felt it necessary to kind of explain where I was coming from.
Okay.
Yeah. Because the videos don't really do a good job of that. And I'm afraid that people are going to think I'm some kind of male chauvinist pig. But I'm really not, because after I know, I'm like, you know, I can see where that very first comment kind of led me down that path.
Okay.
What are you doing? Why are you waving at the dog?
Because she wants to play.
Who does? The dog?
Pepper, yeah.
Tell her we're doing business stuff.
Business stuff.
Yeah.
Pepper, the podcast is happening.
She don't care. She just doesn't care. She's like, what do you want me to do? Mm-hmm. She's over there waving at her. You're just egging her on.
Well, I just want to get her to settle down in one spot.
So by frantically waving at her and getting her all riled up, that's kind of the opposite
of what's the first present or gift?
Oh, gosh. Now, this podcast was originally going to be called Cheap Geek's Guide to Cheap Chinese Crap. Great Unusual Holiday Presents. You know, and I probably should have went that way. It definitely sounds less chauvinistic.
But it also sounds kind of
It does sound kind tacky. Of like disparaging towards Chinese.
Yeah.
And Christmas and gifts.
We're just making everybody angry for Christmas. That's what we're doing.
You know, what are you getting for Christmas? Anger. That's what you're getting from me. The old Cheap Geek podcast, just full of anger.
Uh-huh.
A little vitriol, if you will. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I just think I just broke one of the cheap Chinese Christmas presents. There. I'm screwing it back together. And, you know, the sad thing is that I was going to review this in great and agonizing detail because I thought it was cool.
Yeah.
But the dog found the box, chewed the box, and I think ate the remote control that goes with it because I cannot find that thing anywhere.
Yeah.
But I haven't searched the yard yet where all things appear.
Yes.
Sometimes they're safely protected, encased, if you will, in poo-poo. What? It's true. Remember that time I found half a $5 bill sticking out of a poo-poo? And then you're like, man, that's $5. See, if it was a dollar, I'm like, yeah, well, you know what? That one's done. But $5, man, that's a lunch. So I was like, man. So I went and got a plastic bag. And I, you know, like, okay, and I grabbed it because I'm figuring if it's $5, I'll just throw it in the dishwasher. You know, something like that. I'll clean it up a little bit. I pulled it, and it was only half a $5 bill. I was like, oh, nothing's ever easy.
So,
you know what I mean?
So,
Ben, and I never did find the other half of that $5 bill.
And you know what? When he tried to eat the other $5 bill another time, because...
But why didn't he eat like $1? He always goes for the fives. Maybe they taste better.
It took us a while to realize we shouldn't put our change on the living room table. Yeah. But another time he ate part of a $5 bill. I brought the other half to our bank. Yeah. And our bank had the nerve to tell us that we had to bring at least 60% of the bill
They're
in.
They're like, okay, you need to bring at least 60% of this dog poop flavored $5 bill. Yeah.
Those bastards. They could only replace it if they had at least 60% of it. And that was the other time. Because that time, I actually caught him eating it, so I managed to get the $5 out of his mouth.
So it's entirely possible that the other half of the five that was sticking out like a flag in the old dog poop, that could have been the half you were looking for. See, if we'd have had better communication skills and worked together, we could have pooled our resources and got a whole $5.
A whole poopy $5.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, are any of these gifts in your list $5?
No.
Okay.
Times are different, man.
Yes,
they're
more
difficult. Yeah. Okay. So here we go. Got a lot of stuff going on. Got a lot of stuff to talk about. These are gifts that I thought would be interesting and that any dude would like. And possibly lady dudes. Or, I mean, well, ladies might like these gifts as well. So don't take lady dudes. Okay, stop it. Now people are like, what's a lady dude? Look it up on the internet. It's not what I meant. Whatever you find on the internet, that's exactly not what I was talking about. Okay. I'm going to need you to be serious now. All right, so it's the chocolate chips. They're running all through me. I'm a little worked up, a little wired up here with the old... I wonder what they put in those. It makes them taste so good. All right. So the very first thing is, okay, weather stations, the indoor-outdoor wireless weather stations. It's been a little thing that I've kind of been fascinated with for a while. I think the older you get, the more you like to know what the weather's going to be.
Yeah.
I mean, it's true. You know, sometimes I use that as an excuse, like, well, it's going to be 30. Guess who's not going outside today? Me. And then we can binge watch, like, kung fu movies. And
now, as an older...
one that you're binge watching, was it the How to Kill a Murderer? What is that?
How to Get Away with Murder.
How to Get Away with Murderer if you're in the hood.
No, that's not it.
But no, that show is actually pretty good.
Yeah. But as an older adult now and working in a new workplace, an older adult, I talk about things like the weather. So it's like, oh, well, I don't know this person. I probably should. Let's just try to talk about the weather, you know?
Yeah. And the thing is, the weather around here is boring. Oh, it's hot. It's New Mexico. Yes, it's hot. And it's dry. And the wind's blowing.
And then it gets cold.
And dry. And the wind blows. And they're like, oh, I think there might be snow. What? So, but yeah, the cool thing about this indoor weather station is it's primarily a couple different things. It's not very big. It's pretty small. It's about the size of a small paperback book. It does come with a wireless sensor, a.k.a. instrument. And the instrument does do relative humidity, and it also does temperature and Fahrenheit. And what's the other one? The non-American temperature?
Celsius.
Yeah. But since we're American, I don't care about Celsius. And it has an alarm clock feature built into it. It also has the what the weather is going to be like with a little indicator to determine if you're happy or not, like a little smiley face.
Oh, yeah.
It also tells you, like, the relative humidity, and it does all that stuff and even predicts it. So it's a full-on weather station. And most of the weather stations are expensive.
Yeah.
And this is something I've noticed because I've been interested in it. And it's like you can't find one for, like, $40. It does – like, they'll do dumb stuff like, oh, well, this thing does temperature and time, but it doesn't do humidity. Oh, well, this one does temperature and humidity, but it doesn't do time. Oh, and this one does, you know, it's a hygrometer feature where it actually does weather and you know, how much humidity and how much water, but it doesn't do wind. Yeah. They're always missing something. And they're all, for the most part, stuck way behind the times because you can actually buy some of these instruments that you can plug in. That's what you call stuff that measures weather. You know, like these, and plug into your cell phone and you can, like, turn your smartphone into a weather station, but they're all expensive. Yeah. And we actually carry one in our van.
Mm-hmm.
We actually have two. Because it's kind of good to know what the weather's going to be like when you're in the middle of nowhere. Because sometimes we go places where there's no service or signal.
Mm-hmm.
So, and, you know, you get that walking rain, thunderstorms. But anyway, this thing is made by Smart Gear, and it's $16.
That's not bad.
No, it's the best one I found. And I bought it, and I'm like, this thing is worth $16.
Hmm.
Two-piece set, indoor-outdoor, wirelessly beams outdoor temperature to indoor weather station. Displays indoor-outdoor temperature, humidity, time, date, and the moon phase. See?
Yeah.
And it also has a built-in alarm clock with snooze.
Okay.
It's very nice. I got some chocolate chip stuck in my throat.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's pretty good. That's probably one of the most expensive things on the list. As a matter of fact, it is one of the most expensive things on the list. It's a SmartCore indoor-outdoor weather. And there's going to be a video on this as well. I have 13 videos to do. I will be releasing 2 to 3 videos a day until they're all out. Because I thought about doing like one a day. But then I realized that Christmas would be upon us. And if you wanted to get something for somebody off this list, you wouldn't be able to. So, yeah. All right. So, like every guy out there should know, you should be aware of the weather and be able to talk about it in great and agonizing detail. You should also be able to predict the weather. And you should be able to, you know, say, well, we're going to have to bring in the kids and old people. It's going to get really windy. You know, you should be able to do that kind of thing, right?
Yeah.
So, and that got me thinking about all the tactical stuff. You know, people like tactical stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's tactical. Got to be tactical. Oh, is it black? Well, if you spray paint something black, it becomes blacktical. You know what I mean? Oh, yeah. Is that a tactical knife? Is that a tactical, what is that, tactical backpack? What'd you get to the tactical backpack? And, you know, I'll be honest with you. Until somebody started coining the phrase tactical and extreme, nobody cared. It was just a backpack. It was just a rucksack.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, one of the things that people have been sort of pinging off of in the last couple, I don't know, 3 years or so, is tactical watches.
Okay.
I'm like, oh, hey, is that a Sunto? It's like a $400 tactical watch. And you're like, oh, yeah. If you're not, you know, the operators wear this. And operators are like the tactical people, like SEALs and Rangers and Forest Recon and all the, you know, Chuck Norris type stuff out there, right?
Uh-huh.
And, is that a Sunto? Is that a Sunto? Which one you got there? Zoo Compass? There's like $300 to $400 tactical watch. And I got an argument with somebody about that. I'm like, do you really think that people like the Navy SEALs actually wear a $400 tactical watch when they go on these little missions?
Yeah.
I mean, really?
No.
No. They probably wear like a G-Shock or something like that. So that's what kind of what I was looking at. And my thought was, I don't want to ruin a G-Shock watch, but I do want to be sufficiently tactical. And then I thought about how the whole tactical thing is just really blown up and, you know, people like to kind of make fun of it. So what I found was a giant tactical manly watch. It's a huge watch.
Yeah.
And it looks like serious business. You know?
Yeah.
And it's made in China.
Oh.
And it's $13.
I found the gold yellow version of it too.
Ooh, is that one $14?
This one's $13.97.
Yeah. So. And they come in like 1,000 different colors.
No.
I mean, seriously, they do.
They mostly come in black though.
Well, no, that I mean there's the like the LED backlight changes colors and stuff like that. Yeah. So this giant tactical manly watch is made by Aposon.
Yeah.
The Chinese company, and it's basically a men's large dual dial analog digital quartz electronic sport watch.
Yeah.
And it's huge.
Oh, here's the...
It's like almost 63 millimeters large, and it's really thick. And it's completely waterproof to 50 meters, 164 feet.
I like the note.
The note's... Yeah. The note is... is really kind of what sets it apart from other watches.
Yeah.
Yeah. What does the note say?
Please do not press any buttons in the water.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's mostly tactical, but you better not press any buttons underwater. I don't know if that causes the big giant tactical manly watch to explode.
Yeah.
Or maybe leak, or maybe release some kind of like paralyzing nerve agent or some kind of James Bond tactical type stuff.
Or self
but more than likely, or maybe self-destruct.
Yeah.
I think more than likely what happens is when you press the button is it lets water inside the watch. And, I mean, that's good, though. Because see, if you get captured, you're out being all tactical and you get captured. You don't want to provide your enemy with an additional resource that they didn't have before.
Oh, okay.
So you could basically deprive them from the resource of time. They'll have no idea what time it is. Although this watch is so big, you can see what time it is across the street.
Yeah.
So if you're wearing this big, giant, super awesome tactical manly watch, and somebody asks you what time it is, and they're across the street, you just hold your hand up. You know what I mean? It's like holding up a wall clock. So, but it actually is a pretty cool watch, and I was surprised to find that a lot of people have bought this watch.
Huh.
Yeah, 400 customers, and it rated it 4.5 stars.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, I was like, what? Even though... if you press the buttons of the watch under the water, it may explode. That didn't seem to be a determining factor to detract away from the quality of the watch. So it is a giant watch. So if you got somebody in your family that's all super tactical and stuff, and they talk about all this tactical stuff they have, like tactical pens and tactical flashlights and stuff,
yeah,
you might want to buy this super giant tactical watch.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, it's pretty large. You could probably deflect bullets and stuff.
Oh, wow. So the white version is $403. So
$403?
No, 403 people have bought that one, too.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Those people aren't really tactical.
Oh, okay.
No, they're just, mm-hmm. showing off. Yeah.
So both colors, that's $397 for the original and like $400-something for the white
version.
Yeah, so,
version. 700-800 people it so far. But it does have dual dial. It has two time zones, analog and digital, and it can basically display two different time zones at the same time. It is shock resistant, and it has a stopwatch, and does military time, of course, otherwise it would not necessarily be tactical, and an LED backlight function, and an alarm. And it does have a silicone rubber watch band,
mm-hmm.
which is okay, because some watch bands are actually latex, and that can cause issues.
Issues.
Yeah. So there you go. It's perfect for both indoor and outdoor activities, unless you press the button underwater. You know what I mean? After that, I don't know what happens. So there'll be a video to that coming up pretty soon, and I think we're going to take a little bit of time and do a little commercial. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, everybody. How you doing? We don't really have a commercial for you because, we just don't. But what we do have are links, and you can click on these links on our website. These links will take you to places where you can get stuff, like free trials to Amazon, free trial to Audible, things like that. So stuff that you can get for free. And, hey, if you're really clever, you can give those links away to somebody else and give it to them for free. See? That makes you a giver. And being a giver is good. Being a giver is good.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so we're moving along the list. I will be honest with you and up front for all those people who are listening to podcasts. First off, I do appreciate it. But the next thing on the list is actually something that's not going to have a video made from it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, why?
Well, what it was is it was a super awesome remote control LED color changing light bulb.
Yeah?
Yeah. For $11.
That's impressive.
Yeah, well, the dog ate the box and the remote control, so the only thing it becomes is just a stupid light bulb that just kind of slowly pulses in between the colors. So you can't really control it anymore, so that's why I'm not going to do that.
Oh, okay.
But I will put a link. So if you're actually listening to the podcast and you're kind of curious about a super awesome remote-controlled LED color-changing light bulb, you can click on the link.
Hmm.
But according to this, it's a retro LED color-changing light bulb with remote control.
Ooh.
How can it be retro? LED technology is relatively new, especially for consumer. But anyway, I think it's the fact that it looks like a light bulb. It looks like a regular light bulb. You screw it in a light bulb socket and you use a remote control to change the colors.
Hmm.
Yep. So it has 16 different color choices. You can do different colors. It also will do like a smooth transition between colors. It'll flash. It'll do the strobe. It does like a strobe mode. And they call it energy saving because it's low wattage being LED.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I like what they say. They kind of go like this. They say, have you ever thought that you could change your house's dull yellowish light into an interesting green, blue, red, or white? Well, now you can. These LED lights do not only change amongst these four colors, but they have 12 more bright shades. What? And even flash. With these ingenious lamps, you will never get bored. So I can sit there with this remote control and never get bored.
Okay.
That's what it says.
Yeah. Okay.
And remote control for my convenience.
Oh.
You know? Because what's better than operating your lamp's color mode? Right? Through a handy remote control. While you are still seated comfortably in your sofa. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
With the innovating technology of this set, you definitely can.
This is like the modern day clapper.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Well, it's not really a clapper.
Yeah.
choose your favorite color and also the mode you prefer. Easier than ever.
Okay.
Yep. Easy. You have a wide variety of choices available, including smooth, flash, strobe, 12 different colors.
Yeah.
Right? And brightness level just by pressing some keys. Impressive, right? And see, all this is in, you know, Chinglish, which is Chinese English.
Yeah.
So, yes, it really doesn't make that much sense. You're like, what? It just doesn't go. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like fake.
So, you got the light bulb.
Wait. I'm not even through the best part. It's a unique idea with dozen uses.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Dozen uses.
It'll be their new favorite gadget for your kids.
Yeah.
That's what it says. It's a thoughtful design and it has hassle-free installation. It's a freaking light bulb, so you just screw it in the sock, right?
Yeah.
These 3-watt LED lights, as all LEDs, are energy-saving, environmentally friendly, and there you go.
Okay.
And it won't burden your utility bill at all.
Oh.
Yeah.
Was that in the description?
So I was stupid excited. Oh, yeah. All this is definitely in the description. So I was stupid excited about this, and it was a lightning deal on Amazon Prime.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, I am buying this because it is, you know, this has got to be good.
Yeah.
Right? And it actually is pretty cool unless you don't have a remote control. Then it just becomes this stupid light bulb that doesn't do anything. So there's like no manual default to white.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, hey, no, it's just like just pulses. Yeah. This anemic glow. Because I think when you lose a remote control, it just sort of defaults to a low level, so it's not really bright.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, what are you doing over there? Are you looking at like jewelry?
I am looking at
diamond rings and such.
Some Amazon deals. So yeah, because that might be something we talk about either later on in the podcast.
What? My LED color changing light bulb?
No.
What do you mean? Oh, I see.
Yeah. Some affordable options that are brought to you by Amazon. So, yeah.
Affordable options of what? Like jewelry?
So, jewelry, but since this is a podcast about gifts for guys or guyish peoples, yes.
Well, okay. Be careful.
Yes.
Be careful.
So,
let me show you what I'm talking about.
Okay. Greg is currently plugging in screwing in the color-changing light bulb. Nope. Yeah.
No, it doesn't even work at all.
No, it doesn't even work at all.
So the dog ate the remote control, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
And it's stuck in the off position. So now I can't even use it. So
mm-hmm.
That's sad.
Yeah.
Although I do have a remote control in the van that controls our LED lights. Maybe it's the same one.
It looked like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Hmm. Okay. He's still trying to make it work.
No, I'm just trying to, you know.
Okay.
Yes, I'm trying to make it work. Disheartened.
But for, what, $11? That's quite a deal.
Just don't lose the remote control, because then it's useless. And it's pretty hard to show off when you can't make it work. You know, hey, check this out. See what it does?
Nothing.
Oh, yeah, it does nothing. That's great, yeah. I have an uncle that does nothing, too, right? You want to come over and see him? Okay. So here's something else that's actually pretty cool. This is a car charger with an LED geek screen on it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Geek screen?
Yes. Okay. It's been a...
What is a geek screen?
I'm glad you asked.
Okay.
What this is a dual USB car charger, and it has a blue LED display on it. It's pretty small.
Mm-hmm.
Displays voltage, amps, and internal temperature.
Okay.
Yeah.
That works.
For a total of 3.1 amps or 15 watts. It's compatible with most Android, Windows, you know, it's phones, man, whatever you plug into it.
Yeah.
Yep. Yes, it is.
Okay.
It's very nice. So pretty much what it does is it uses smart technology to ensure that each device you plug in gets the right amount of amperage, 3.1 total amps, and it'll sit there and show you how cold it is outside. It'll also show you how much juice your car battery has and what amps you're using.
Hmm.
Very nice.
Yeah. Useful, too.
Yeah. And it has an auto power off when the input or output is greater than what it can handle, so it prevents it from being overheated.
Yeah.
So it's actually kind of cool. You plug it in your cigarette lighter, you get in there, you turn the key, and it defaults to temperature. So, you know, oh, it's like 37 degrees, you know, or, oh, hey, it's like 50.
Yeah.
And when you plug in your smartphones and or tablet or whatever, it charges it at the right rate, so it'll actually charge.
Yeah.
Because some of these chargers, especially if you have an old charger, they don't charge as good as, you know, they could. Because the rate of charge does not exceed the rate of discharge.
Okay.
Which just means that when you're using your device, like say you have like Google Maps up trying to navigate, your phone is using more energy than what the charger is putting into it, and so your phone just keeps dying.
Yeah.
And doesn't actually charge. So this thing will, and it has a little LED screen on it. And I think it's pretty cool. And it's blue.
That is cool.
Not red.
And how much was this?
$6.
Ooh, okay. That's worth it. Especially like if you go to a box store, like an actual physical retail store, any charger is at least $8.
That's true.
So, yeah.
So it's a 4-in-1.
Ooh.
But, you know, it's $6, so it's a good little pocket, what do we call it? A pocket stuffer?
Stocking stuffer.
Stocking stuffer.
Yes.
Because if you're unilateral pocket stuffer, you're probably stealing. You know what I mean? Okay, so, yeah, that was something that was pretty neat,
mm-hmm.
and there'll be a video for that. And, yeah, that's enough of that.
Okay.
Oh, charging cable not included.
Oh, so it's...
And the LEDs are bright enough to read the display without being a distraction while driving.
No. You can actually just, you know, look at it real quick and not, yeah.
Well, it's not, like, super bright.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so the next thing is something that goes along the lines of the charger I was talking about. It's made by Ravtech, and it's a mini wireless charging pad.
Okay.
You know what that is, right?
Kind of.
Well, go ahead.
It is basically a pad that you can lay down like a smartphone device or something.
Like a tablet?
Yeah.
Smartphone?
Yeah.
What else?
And a smartphone, tablet,
pager.
Really?
Palm Pilot, calculator.
Really?
No.
Okay. Okay.
So what it is, it's a wireless charging pad. And when you lay your device on it, if your device is actually able to do wireless charging, it charges your phone or your tablet.
Cool.
Yep.
All right. And how much is that?
$8.
That's not bad.
No, it's not, because the cool thing is it's a newer version, so it charges quickly.
Mm-hmm.
But the USB cable that's built into it is actually built into it. So the cable won't get frayed. The port won't get all loose and wobbly. The whole thing is covered in a really nice soft rubber,
yeah.
And it charges quick.
Cool.
Yeah. And, you know, it's low profile, so it's pretty small. It's anti-slippery rubber pad. It's wherever you stick it.
Mm-hmm.
And it does a bless you.
Sorry.
Sneezing. But yeah, it does a really good job, and it's pretty convenient because if you don't have like a really thick case on your phone, you know, you just lay it next to your bed on this on the wireless charging thing, and it charges.
Okay.
No more fiddle around with the USB cable because this is really annoying. And I had a tablet that I wasn't using because of the loose USB port.
Yeah.
As it wouldn't charge, so I got this thing, and it's like $8, and it's the best wireless charging pad I've seen for $8.
Okay.
And basically what you do is it uses USB, so you want to make sure you have good USB power. And, you know, if you have like a wall wart where you have you take your phone cable and plug it in, you can use that. You can also use it in your car.
All right.
And the charger I just talked about, the blue LED charger, will actually charge that charging pad just fine. So there you go.
Cool.
So if you really wanted to, for $6 and for $7 or $8, $15, you can hook somebody up with a charging pad. So, and it's kind of nice to have, you know, a wireless inductive charger done through the power of magnetism and electricism, you know, all at the same time.
Yeah.
And you just lay it down. You know, no fiddling around there.
Huh.
Yeah. So, I mean, why not? Guys would like that.
Yeah.
Yep. So that's enough for that one. And there'll be a video on that too. And I kind of did a video about that before when I was talking about my tablet. But now we're going to get into some good stuff.
Okay.
This is something that I think you should go ahead and talk about in great and agonizing detail. Go ahead.
Mora knife.
See, it's Swedish.
Okay.
Like the fish.
Ew. I don't like those. Anyways, the Mora knife companion fixed blade outdoor knife stainless steel blade 4.1 inch. Only $10 on average on Amazon right now. Depending on when you listen to this podcast or click on the show notes, because all these will be in the show notes, it's anywhere from $8.50 to about $14 tops.
Yeah.
So it's actually rated 5 stars out of over 1,700 customers.
Yeah.
So that's pretty good. There are other blades out there. They're all over YouTube. And they have their own ratings and fans and not fans of. But this one seems to be doing pretty good on Amazon.
It's a really inexpensive knife, and it is really utilitarian in its uses. Yeah.
Other knives in the same range usually are a lot more.
So, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And it's a, you know, it's one of the, okay, if you're like a bushcrafting guy,
yeah,
you know, then you know about this knife. If you are, like, if you work in Sweden, you know about this knife.
Okay.
If you go hiking out in Europe, you probably have one of these.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Really popular knife. It's simple. It's utilitarian. They come like almost razor sharp straight from the factory. You can sharpen them. They're stainless steel so that they don't stain. Now, stainless will stain over time, but it's really meant, it's like a worker's knife.
Yeah.
Yeah. Different colors, different types, different lengths, but the companion is really popular, and it's generally really cheap.
Yeah.
And they're so cheap, and it comes with a sheath. Yeah. And they're so cheap that people typically have, the people that buy these knives and have one typically have more than one.
Oh, wow. So you can get the green one right now for like $13.85.
The green and black one?
Yeah. Oh, no. This is just the military green one.
All green?
Yeah. But then the black one, the all black one, which includes the black blade, that one kind of hopped up in price a little bit.
Yeah. I mean, so definitely shop around.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, $14 is a little high for the companion.
Yeah.
You know, $10, $11, sure. $8.50 like it was over the weekend. So just kind of keep an eye on them because they do drop in price.
Yeah.
But, you know, good for hiking, good for camping, good to have all around. And, you know, some people, initially when they look at the knife, they're like, oh, it just looks like a plain knife. But after a while, it becomes a favorite.
Yeah.
Yeah, so nobody's going to complain if you get this. And it's a really good gift.
Okay.
Oh, and if somebody, like if your dude already has one or your lady has one, get them a different color.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, they
really
have
like
it in magenta pink, so.
Yep,
yeah.
And orange and blue and all sorts of colors, and they have different types as well. But the companion does have the 4.1 inch blade, and you can get it in stainless steel or the high density carbon, which is a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
Has a little bit of a darker finish to the blade, but you can't go wrong with either one of them. So, really good gift. Really like it.
Ooh.
Yeah. What do you win over?
The other one on our list.
Yes. So, good knife to get for somebody. And it doesn't matter how old they are either. I mean, I wouldn't get it for a little kid, but, you know, if uncle, dad, whatever, buy them one, man. Any kind of a bug out bag or backpack, emergency kit, something like that, this knife would go well in there.
Okay.
Yeah. And, you know, it's not like if you lose it or destroy it, you're not out a whole lot of money, but it's a good knife. I mean, it has a rubber grip and, you know, it's pretty beefy.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they have a really good warranty, too.
Okay.
Yeah. That's all I'm going to say about that. And it does come with plastic sheath, you know, I should say. You push it in there and it kind of clicks into place. Some people love it. Some people hate it. Okay. A lot of people like to mod it, where they'll do different things to the sheath and they'll change it up a little bit. It's a really popular knife, so. The Mora knife, the companion series, is really cool. Look it up on YouTube. You'll see. Just do Mora knife. M-O-R-A. And you'll see a lot of posts.
Okay.
Yeah. And speaking of knives, we'll move on to this one. This one, every man needs a pocket knife.
Okay.
You know? Because it's utilitarian in function. You can cut a box, peel an apple, you know, whatever. Whatever you need a knife for, a little folding knife is good to have. And one of my favorites is the Gerber Ripstop 1.
Yeah, I like this one.
And it's got a really nice sharp edge on it. It's lightweight. It's sort of skeletal in design, which I kind of like about it. It has an easy out. It has a nice little pocket clip. It also has a dual thumb stud, so you can do it left-handed or right-handed. It has a locking blade. It has a crossover lock in the back where when you open the blade up all the way, the little piece pops over.
Mm-hmm.
And so it locks it inside the knife channel.
Yep.
I like that.
I really like this one.
So when you slide it over and you lock it in place, it's locked. And then when you're done, you just push it back over and the whole thing drops.
Okay.
And it's not very big. Total length is 5.75 inches.
Mm-hmm.
And it weighs about 2 ounces. And it's a nice sort of silver. Not too crazy. And it's made by Gerber. I like Gerber. Some people don't like Gerber and complain. But, you know, I'm not going to get into a knife war with people. Some people are serious. They're like, well, I like Kershaw and I like this. And, you know, I can't believe you're using a Gerber.
You're going to bring.
Not doing it.
You're going to bring facts to a knife fight.
Yeah. And this knife is nice. It's really lightweight. It's a streamlined design. And I've been carrying a Gerber Easy Out. It's about the same size for like 25 years.
Okay.
And my dad gave it to me. So if that knife lasts any bit as long as the one that I'm currently carrying,
yeah,
it's totally worth it.
Okay.
And it does have a lifetime warranty. And here's the good thing. It's $7.
Yeah.
On Amazon. $7.
Yeah. Let's see. $6.43.
Even better.
Yep.
It's $6.43 on Amazon.
Yeah.
Totally worth it. It's an excellent knife. I like it a lot. And 402 people have rated it 4.5 stars.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty compact, but I really like the skeletal design. Yep. And I like it since I carry it in my front pocket. You're not going to get a lot of lint, weird stuff going on.
Okay.
And the blade's pretty sharp, and it's pretty stout. It's a good blade. And I think it's worth the money. I mean, come on, it's $7.
I know.
Buy two of them. You know what I mean? So, I mean, it's worth the knife to carry around that much, so. And, yeah, I like the color, too. It's not tactical, but it is silver.
Okay.
Yep. It's very, very nice.
Hmm.
Yeah.
And then, oh, so you're going to talk about these ones?
Go ahead.
Cheap Chinese driving lights and the 22.5-inch LED light bar.
Yes.
Oh, wow. Okay, so the daytime running lights, those are only $11.99. And basically everything in this list is going to brighten up your drive home at night.
Yes.
Yeah. Greg installed the light bar, it was light bar, right?
And the driving lights.
And the driving lights onto the van, and it's so bright, you can see the future. So
it's super awesome.
Yeah. It's blinding, almost. So, little heads up. I think what the little lights that are at the bottom of the van, you did need to wire those. So, I don't really know much about that part, and you should talk.
Well, okay, the 22.5-inch light bar, I actually got to go on our bull bar,
mm-hmm.
right? And I started doing research, and the most inexpensive, best thing I could find was like 12 inches at the same cost.
Okay.
And I knew I wanted to have at least 24 inches or close to it. So it actually filled up that space on the bull bar. Mm-hmm. So when I first found it, right?
Yeah.
It was listed at $15.99. So I immediately bought one because everything else was triple the price.
Okay.
And that's the low end. I mean, they go up to almost like $1,000 depending on what you're looking at. It's average is like $300 to $400 for a good one.
Oh, gosh.
As soon as it showed up, I opened it up, the box, and I checked it all out. I'm like, no way, this is actually really good. And then you said, I want one for my truck.
Yeah.
So I'm like, well, I'm going to go get another one because the price at $15 was totally worth it, or $16.
Yeah.
And when I logged in and checked, for some reason, they were down to $9.99. So I immediately bought one. I'm like, yeah, okay, boom, boom, done.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, okay, they're going to cancel the order because it's obviously a mistake. Because when I checked 3 hours later, it was like $19.99.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then I checked again, like 4 hours later, and the price got went back down to $16. So it was like they somehow or another were doing something, and they made a mistake.
Huh.
Yeah, and they're like right at either $16.99 or $19.99.
Okay.
Which is still an excellent value for the cost.
Yeah.
These things light up very well. They have a flood pattern at both ends and a spot in the middle. I have a mine pointed at the road in front of me.
Mm-hmm.
And it's still very bright. I can see the edges of the road. I mean, you know, I did a video on it so you can see.
Yeah.
And I have that one set up. I bought a wiring harness. The wiring harness has a remote control, so I can actually turn it on and off because I didn't want to wire through my firewall because it's kind of an aggravation being in a van.
Okay.
But it's very convenient. And the the driving lights I have, as soon as you turn the headlights on, the driving lights come on. Those have been really, really nice. They're small. Nice output as far as the light goes and the lumens. Mm-hmm. The price is right. And, yeah, you do have to wire these up, but you can buy, like, a wiring kit where it comes with a switch and a regular fuse and a, what do you call them, voltage regulator. Not a voltage regulator. What was that thing called? Anyway, it comes with everything you need. And they're not that bad. They're really easy to wire up. And, yeah, I've been really happy that I did that. And I originally had a budget of like $100 because I was having a hard time seeing at night. And I spent maybe total like 60.
Yeah.
And that 60 has given me two light bars because one's yours.
Yep.
Kind of like that's going to be one of your little Christmas presents.
Okay. I'm fine with that. So
it's actually pretty cool. But that's for, you know, and the driving lights, everything has been like $60. So totally worth it. So if you have a truck or something like that and you're thinking about getting a light bar.
Yeah.
But you don't want to spend like $300 because you're not sure if you actually want the light bar. Hmm. Buy this. I mean, you could use it on something else if you don't want to use it like on your truck. You know, maybe you want to put it on like a Subaru, whatever, man. I mean, you can totally, it's totally worth the money. So,
okay.
Yeah. And the cool thing about it is, or the funny thing about it is, it's basically repackaged and distributed by a company called Cute Queen from China.
Yeah. So when it arrived and he had these two long, rectangular boxes that said Cute Queen, I was kind of thinking, did he order me nail stuff for Christmas? Because that sounds like, you know, some sort of nail salon equipment, not light bars. So
yeah. Well, I bought some LED stuff from those guys before, so
yeah,
really happy with the overall quality. Totally worth buying. So yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And here's something that's kind of like that, but a little bit different.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen those big cups that people were all excited about for a while? The campers and the workers out there. You'd like this big stainless steel tumbler from Yeti.
And it's got its own like 4 minute long commercial on YouTube.
And you have to like buy a separate handle and a lid and it's double vacuum insulated and you know, it's 18-8 stainless steel and drinks stay hot.
Yep.
And ice stays cold for up to 24 hours.
Hmm.
Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
And they come in different sizes, but like the 30-ounce tumbler was the really popular size, and people were going crazy.
Okay.
And they were spending like $40 on a stainless steel cup. I was like, I am not spending $40 on a cup. I don't care. Well, I found a couple different versions of the Yeti cup. Number one is the one from Yeti, whose price has actually dropped to about $29 for a 30-ounce tumbler.
Okay.
The next one is made by a company called Arctic, and it's R-T-I-C. So it's supposed to be like the Arctic.
Mm-hmm.
And their tumbler is $11.99.
Hmm.
And it's 30 ounces. It looks exactly the same thing as the Yeti, but it just says Arctic on it. And the results have been really similar. So I thought that was pretty good for $11.99. But it gets even better because there's a Walmart version.
Yeah.
A Ozark Trail version in Walmart.
Ozark Trail?
Yeah.
Okay.
And you go back by the camping section and you can get the same stainless steel cup, 30 ounce tumbler for like $8.
Wow.
Yeah.
And it comes with a handle, don't it?
No, it does not.
Oh, okay.
But you can buy the handle separately for like $2.
Okay.
So I've compared them both the Arctic and the Ozark Trail, and you can't go wrong with your one.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good.
And as far as hot stuff goes, it'll keep stuff hot for about 4 hours. And that's basically from start to, and by the end of the 4 hour period, your liquid is still above room temperature, which is really good for a cup of coffee to last that long as far as the heat goes.
Mm-hmm.
Because the cup I use now, it's like I pour it and it's kind of like room temperature by the time I get to work. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But using the Arctic or the Ozark Trail tumbler, it stays hot a lot longer. Now, where these things really shine is where it's cold.
Yeah.
You put ice in these things and it'll last all day. I mean, 24 hours almost worth of ice.
Wow.
Worth of, you know, you put ice in it and it'll last about that long. And, yeah, totally worth it. And you know, spending $8.99 or about between $8 and $9 for a cup and then $2.50 for a handle and with the lid and everything. I'm not one of these people who spend a lot of money on coffee cups or just, you know, tumbler.
Mm-hmm.
Totally worth it. And so I can see when we go out and go camping or go somewhere, like, you know, sometimes we like take off in the mornings and we go like all day long. My coffee will stay hot like all day.
Yeah.
And I'm good with that. Especially if you get up early in the morning or if you have to like, you know, do like a long commute to work.
Yeah.
Totally worth it. And there's another company out there that makes stuff, but I've seen them in Walmart, like the Bubba cups.
Yeah.
The people are like, I don't like this. They're kind of big. They don't really fit the cup holder. You know, so it gets a little unwieldy, you know. Like one guy I know with his Bubba cup, it was all tapered almost like a tumbler.
Yeah.
He'd use like a roll of duct tape to keep it steady.
Yeah.
You know, I don't, you know, because he put the cup in the hole and then just set it on the floorboard.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. Then the Arctic cup, the Yeti cup, and the Ozark Trail, I should say the tumbler, totally fits in the cup holder. Totally worth it. And you can even you can even eat it out of this thing, man. You can put like some hot soup in there or something like that. But you don't want to put these in the dishwasher. These are like hand wash only.
Okay.
Yeah. But yeah, totally worth it. So if you're thinking about buying somebody like a Yeti for like $30, don't do it. Get them an Arctic, get them an Ozark Trail. You know. If the Yeti's like buy one, get one free, I'd think about it. But I mean overall I've been really impressed and so has everybody else.
Okay.
So these things are high quality, man. And the lids made out of food grade polypropylene, lightweight. They have like excellent grip, and you know it's not bad. And I even put a link in there so you know where to buy the handle, because you can buy the handle with a different spill proof lid,
yeah.
And it does make the heat last a little bit longer. But if you're worried about cold, man, is all day. Like ice will stay in these cups for up to 24 hours, and that's no joke.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, you fill it full of ice, come back 24 hours later, you still have ice in the cup. Now, some of it's going to melt, of course. But, I mean, come on, that's serious business.
Yeah.
There's a lot of coolers that you buy out there that won't even do that.
No.
Yeah, and I like the tumblers because they're kind of narrow and tall.
Huh.
So they fit in the cup holder. And, you know, it's just more convenient. So, Yeah. So, remember I was kind of talking about backpacks a little bit?
Yes.
We're getting pretty close to the end of this list. There's been like a lot of things to talk about. there's a place called National Parks Depot.
Yes.
And they sell a military-styled tactical backpack.
Oh.
And it's like about $20 if you use a 5% coupon. So normally it's like $25.
Okay.
And it looks amazing, this backpack. But it's not. If you can find it for like $15,
yeah,
it just is barely worth $15.
Okay.
And don't get me wrong, it's a good backpack, and I'm a little bit of a backpack snob,
mm-hmm.
or a pack whore, I guess, if you want to look at it like that. And there's some certain things I don't like, but I would definitely keep this backpack in my car full of stuff that would, you know, help keep me alive if I broke down on the side of the road.
Okay.
But I would not use this as a primary hiking pack because I think it – Some of the seams need to be re-sewn or double-sewn. Some of the connecting points need to be double-box sewn. You know, some of the plastic hardware needs to be a little bit thicker. It's just what it is I've been spoiled with LA police gear.
Yeah.
Which has a dirt cheap bag that you have to break in. It takes like years to break these bags in. But once you get them broken in, they're amazing.
Yeah.
And I've been kind of spoiled with that. But I mean, as far as like if you don't have a backpack and you're looking for something like this, mm-hmm. you know, the military style backpack that you find from National Parks Depot.
Yeah.
It's okay.
It's okay.
Yeah. It's like the 20 liter bag is pretty good. It's made out of 600D nylon. And it's like 17x9x9, so it's not too big. And it's, you know, it has like different pouches for holding water bladders and different things like that. Integrated Molly, so you can clip on different things.
And I'm kind of sold on Osprey. That's my.
I mean, Osprey packs are great too, but you know, yeah. I like Mountain Smith. If I'm going to buy like a nylon style backpack, like Osprey or REI or whatever, mm-hmm. I'm a Mountain Smith guy. Period.
For me, it's fit. So
yeah, Mountain Smith fits me pretty well too. Yeah. But I mean, if I'm looking like at a regular, like a manly tactical stuff, I get LA police gear. I don't know. Tactical 511's cool and all, but it ain't worth the cost. Red Rock's not nearly as good. You know, I'm seriously LA police gear, amazing bags for stupid cheap. But I do like your Osprey pack. It just doesn't fit me right. So
yeah, and that's my thing. The way they fit on the back for me, that's going to be most important. I'll work with the rest of a bag, like the rest of the technology in it. But if it doesn't fit the actual my shoulder frame and my back, I can't wear it.
Water.
So yeah.
Yes, I'm very thirsty all of a sudden.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's because it's winter and we both got colds. So.
Pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
So this is actually pretty cool. You need a little small pin light, a little tactical pin light.
Yeah.
Yeah. Flashlight technology's come a long way. I mean, they have like memory now where they remember the last position you're in and all stuff. And yeah, this Thorfire, it's a small pin light. It's AAA LED flashlight. So it only holds one little battery. It has one LED, one Cree LED. Very small, has a metal clip. It's all metal. It's this little tactical version of the upgraded version of the PF-01. It's the PF-01S is smaller, brighter, has more memory built into it. Or actually has memory, I should say.
Yeah.
And it's got a max lumens of 120, which isn't a whole lot. But this thing is like a little bit bigger than the battery that goes in it. So it's completely portable.
Okay.
It'll go in your pocket for everyday carry, that kind of thing. And, you know, if you want to carry around a flashlight, it's smaller than a lighter. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I can totally see carrying it around. And it is pretty heavy duty, so totally worth it. Shop around. The average price right now is $14.99. So if you got a tactical dude and you're trying to figure out what to get them, chances are they don't have a AAA LED flashlight.
Yeah.
Because they're very small, and most of them aren't really worth the money. But this has the clip on it, and it's all metal. And I like it.
Ooh.
So, yeah.
I saw something else in the suggested links that I like.
Okay. What is it?
Tactical LED pen knife with glass breaker, 4-in-1 pen, LED light knife survival, and self-defense coupon.
Yeah. That's serious business.
$19.99. Oh, but, and they actually, they must have paid a 20-year-old here in the United States to write the description.
Yeah.
Self-defense pen. So sexy, you can, like, put it in sleek.
You can, like, punch people in the face and stab them with the pen and write all over their face.
No, because they used all the keywords. They used all the necessary keywords. EDC carry clip. Great gift idea.
Oh, yeah.
Coupon glass breaker. So, like, all that's in
that's
all
my
caps.
Wrestling name.
Yeah.
Coupon glass breaker. Yeah, pretty cool. So it's a good little flashlight, and you know what? It's small to keep in your pocket or in your glove box.
Okay.
Totally worth it. Itty bitty. Here's something I was really impressed to get and very happy.
Okay.
Ozark Trail, right? Walmart. If you're in Walmart, they had, and this was amazing at the time, the 3-piece cast iron skillet set on sale.
Yeah.
It was, we're talking about the 8-inch, the 10.5-inch, and the 12-inch skillets.
Yeah.
Remember what we paid for it? What was it?
$15?
$15.
Yeah.
For a pretty decent overall quality cast iron skillet set.
Hmm.
And the cheapest I found aside from $15 was Harbor Freight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How much
now, you're not going to find a Lodge set like this for, you know, unless you buy it used somewhere and somebody doesn't know what they got. But for the most part, like the Lodge 8-inch pan was like $20.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This was a set of three, 8, 10.5 and 12 inches. $15 is what we paid for it. Right now they're at 20, and that's still a good deal.
Okay.
Yeah. See, because here's the reason why people say buy one brand over the other. And usually it's the finish of the pan itself. You know?
Yeah.
Not the outside, but the cooking section. Because when you get them and you get them all seasoned up, the more seasoned they are, the better they cook. And stuff doesn't stick to them. Because a lot of people say, I don't like cast iron pans because stuff sticks to it. It just means it's not seasoned right.
Okay.
Because if you get one that's seasoned right, I mean, it's like cooking with Teflon, man. Stuff just slides around in there, and it gives it a nice, good taste. And it's nothing cooks better than cast iron. If you get it seasoned right. And here's a trick. Give you a little tip. If you buy one of these inexpensive cast iron skillet sets like we did, we paid $15. If you buy one from Walmart, you're going to pay $20.
Mm-hmm.
And the bottom is not quite as smooth as you want. It's cast iron. Sand it. Get a heavy grit sandpaper and make it smooth. You know, start with 90 grit or 60 grit and work your way to 100, 120, whatever.
Yeah.
Smooth out the bottom. You can do that. It's just a pan. It's cast iron. And once you got it smooth the way you like it, wash it and re-season it. You can take a cheap pan, as long as the structure is good. You don't have too many pockets or divots or anything like that. Just sand cast was good. And you can sand it down and smooth it out and re-season it, and you'll have an amazing pan. And the thing is to make sure that it's even, like the cast is even, where the metal is the right thickness all the way around, and it's even. It should have a good weight to it, you know, that kind of thing.
Okay.
But the Ozark Trail, that was a good deal. And they're really not bad. They're not bad at all for the cost. And I could not believe we got it for $15. Even if I seen it at $20, I probably jumped on it because I thought it was a great deal.
Yeah.
And the good sizes, too, 8, 10, and 12.
Okay.
And we're going to use it for camping and everything else. And, you know, why not put it on the fire? And it'll last forever. Now, these actually come pre-treated already using the plant oil.
Yeah.
Doesn't say what it is, but it says comes, you know, it's treated, seasoned with plant oil. Well, I'm going to sand all that stuff off, and I'm going to make our pans, like, super smooth and re-season it, and then we'll probably use EVO.
Okay.
Extra virgin olive oil.
Okay.
Yep. So, all right, we are getting powerfully close to the very end of this list.
Yes.
And the last thing on the list is probably should have been the first thing on the list. If you got a dude out there and they're not really going to celebrate the holidays because they don't want to buy the tree and do all that stuff.
Yeah.
They can get a 32-inch USB fiber optic Christmas tree for $15.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
$15.
We actually bought it.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks good. I mean, the fiber optic, there's a lot of them, so it does change colors. But the cool thing is it's powered through USB.
Yeah. So you can plug it into
a wall. You can plug it in. You can plug it into your computer.
Yeah.
You can plug it into a battery pack. You can make this Christmas tree completely portable.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it looks good because the little blades that are on there, the little pine needles,
mm-hmm.
they're not needles. They're flat, and it fluffs out nice, and it comes with a base,
yeah.
and it's USB.
Like I had to shake it out. And then I move the arms around, and now it just looks like, you know, like a normal Christmas tree.
Yeah, it looks good. It doesn't look like a little Charlie Brown crappy that you pulled it out of a box Christmas tree. And at night, when you turn the lights off, all those fiber optic points, it looks really cool. I mean, I'm proud of myself for buying a $15 Christmas tree.
Yes.
It is very nice. So if you know somebody out there who maybe is probably not going to outwardly display the holiday spirit, I guess, because for whatever reason, maybe they can't. You know, maybe you get them a little Christmas tree. I mean, it's totally worth it, and it can be, you know, USB powered, so it's like powered by batteries almost.
Okay.
So, you know, and that's something too, because, you know, you don't have to leave it plugged in. You know, you could, like, do a battery, like a battery pack or battery bank.
Yeah.
If the battery dies, it just goes out. So you could actually take this thing camping, really, if you wanted to. You could put it in a kid's room, too. It's USB powered, so.
You could take it with you and do some, like, light photography at night.
That's true. Mm-hmm. You could also take it at the end of the Christmas season and attack it with a drone.
Okay.
Maybe you can attack it over a drone. It can, you know. But, yeah, if we put some googly eyes on it, it could be, you know, you can, like, sing the Golden Girls song.
Oh, no.
With a Christmas tree.
Right, okay.
Thank you for being my friend. Okay. You know, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Anyway, there we go. We have a whole bunch of stuff. I'm pretty sure we covered most everything that was on the list. I'm trying to think if there's anything that we missed on the list. I don't think so.
No.
There's going to be videos for every one of these things we talked about, with the exception of the super old, awesome LED color-changing light bulb that I can't find a remote control because the dog ate it. Which actually is kind of sad.
Yeah.
So.
I guess that dog's not getting anything for Christmas.
That's kind of mean, right?
He's not listening extreme. To me.
He's totally, no, he's not.
Okay.
So anyway, there you go. I just figured we'd kind of do this little podcast to talk about some of the things and some of the reasons behind why we're getting it. So just kind of do a little recap if you don't remember. Wireless weather station, giant tactical manly watch. Right? Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Super awesome LED remote color changing light bulb. The link will be there, but I'm not going to do a video on it. Car charger with LED geek screen so you can know what the temperature is, the amps is, and the volts is, so you know when your battery is dead, right? Which is kind of nice. A mini charging pad so you don't have to fumble around with USB cables. The Mora knife is the best knife ever for the cost. It is a really good knife. I mean, for less than $10, you get a knife that can last 100 years. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
The Gerber Ripstop awesome little pocket knife for $7 of good quality. The light bar, the driving lights, totally worth it. Everything on this list is under $20, you know?
Yeah.
The cool tumbler that'll keep your ice cold for 24 hours, mm-hmm. you know, and a handle. That's super cool. The backpack, which is like $20. Eh, I'm kind of iffy on that one.
Mm-hmm.
A really cool pen light that's LED with Cree LED, uses one AAA battery and lasts a long time. That thing is actually pretty neat. You'll like that.
Okay.
And a cast iron cook set for less than $20. All these things are you know, gifts that I would like to have. I think most people would, honestly.
Cool.
You know, you're just saying that.
Like, okay. Yeah,
great. Okay. All right.
No, because I'm looking at some other interesting stuff, too. So.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep.
Well, anyway, we just thought we'd kind of do this a little bit, and that's what we're going to do. So that was episode number 18 of the Cheap Geek Podcast. If you'd like to follow us along on our internet stuff, you can do that.
Yep. You can reach us on Instagram, instagram.com/CheapGeekPodcast. I'm on Instagram as The Ordinary Hiker, all one word. We are on Facebook. You can go to facebook.com/groups/CheapGeek page. We are accepting members. Just give us some time and be patient. We'll approve your membership. Now, if you want to comment about the show, reach us at podcast@cheapgeek.net. Business inquiries, cheapgeek@cheapgeek.net. You can reach Greg at greg@cheapgeek.net. Or me, that's going to be omi@cheapgeek.net. And that's about it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I like being
so a anyway, there you go. Thanks for listening. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, drop us a line. But yeah, we're going to do a couple more of these podcasts like before the end of the holidays. But for now, see you later. Take it easy. Bye-bye.
Bye.